just a few days until Election Day, my guest this week is Mitt Romney's New Hampshire campaign director, Phil Valenziano. Phil, thank you so much for coming in. We've got just a couple of days before Election Day. What do you think are going to be the key things that undecided voters will be making up their minds about?
Well, certainly, you know, the key issue of this campaign from the very beginning has been who will give us the best shot to have a strong economy moving forward. People have taken a look at what the president's done over the last 4 years. They seem to be unhappy with it, and I know Governor Romney's plan for the future will give us more jobs, less debt, and higher take-home pay.
So people seem to appreciate this race, that. So if you look at polling, has been tight as a tick. So. Give the case. Why is Mitt Romney going to win New Hampshire?
Oh, well, you know, we've got a superior turnout operation. I know that our friends on the other side of the aisle have about three times as many staff, three times as many offices. But when you look at the amount of voters contacted by each campaign, nearly identical. So we've been able to really contact a lot of voters, talk to a lot of people about the reasons why Mitt Romney is the best choice for our country moving forward.
So when we look at the fact that Mitt Romney is coming to the state twice in the last weekend before New Hampshire, what does that mean? How are we supposed to interpret that? This is a toss-up here. He's not going to Ohio twice.
Well, you know, I don't know his full schedule. Forgive me. I just know when he's coming to New Hampshire. But Governor Romney has always believed that New Hampshire was very important. Mm-hmm. Obviously, he kicked off his campaign here. Then he kicked off the second phase of it after the primary here. And we are going to wrap it up here on Monday night. And we're also lucky enough to get him in Portsmouth on Saturday morning. New Hampshire is obviously very, very close. We've known that it would be from the very beginning. And I think the fact that Governor Romney is coming twice between now and Election Day shows the campaign's commitment to winning the state of New Hampshire.
How critical was that first debate in terms of firing up your volunteers?
You know, I think it was pretty important, but we've been very happy with our volunteer level from the very beginning of this campaign. Mm-hmm. There clearly was an appetite there, a large amount of enthusiasm for working hard to change the direction of our country, and Governor Romney obviously being that change in direction. So we saw a little bit of an uptick after the first debate, but we've really seen an explosion of volunteerism in the last 2 weeks, actually.
Wonderful.
Yeah,
good.
It's great.
Thank you for coming in. Now, you can read more about the upcoming election at WMUR.com/political scoop. That's also where you can watch an extended version of this interview. But that does it here for TV. Now back to you. Well, you mentioned your friends. We have a few more moments here online.
Sure.
You mentioned your friends on the other side, and we have had your counterpart on this segment. And, you know, they talk about, you know, metrics-driven campaigns, and I know it's the new way of doing things here. Clearly, Republicans did up here in 2004. But you've pointed out consistently that you guys are hitting your targets better than McCain ever did.
Oh, certainly. At this point, comparative to 2008, we have made seven times more door knocks. We've knocked seven times more doors.
Wow.
And we have made well over two times as many phone calls. So the effectiveness of our grassroots operation can't be compared to any year. We are light years ahead of where we were. I know our absentee ballot program has been great. The reception there has been very positive. We're currently leading by 4 points over the Democrats in the party breakdown of people who have requested absentee ballots, so we're happy about that. And, we've got more offices, more staff than we had prior, but we have seen just a stunning increase in volunteer
level. You mentioned before, and I'm glad you did, you know, Obama's been here for some time. Obviously, the Romney campaign had to go
6 years.
The Romney campaign after the New Hampshire primary had to go win other states. That's something I think is part of your experience.
I did have a little bit to do with that.
with Governor Romney. But, you know, now they have like 150 staffers. They have 22 offices. You said it's a third and a third. You know, you guys have 12 offices, I understand.
It's nine.
It's nine, okay. I read somewhere it's 12. I thought it was still nine. Why doesn't that matter? Why doesn't that organization matter for Obama?
Well, I won't speak to what their internal thought process is, but we've always been able to think about it in terms of contacting the right amount of voters.
Uh-huh.
Now, it seems like they need to have a million offices to do that. We are going to be able to do it with our amount of offices. We obviously are contacting a very similar amount of voters. When you talk about, during some of these surveys, they ask, have you been contacted by the Obama campaign or have you been contacted by the Romney campaign? The numbers are identical.
Mm-hmm.
Identical. So the number of offices somebody has, the number of
sure.
staffers somebody has, matters perhaps, but when it comes down to actually contacting voters,
yep.
it's been parity. And that's because we work very smart and very hard.
You know, one of your jobs, not to tell you your job, but I think one of your jobs is to figure out a voter model in this state, try to figure out where you need to target. This past week, we had Secretary of State Bill Gardner give out his turnout estimate, which showed it pretty high, in fact, even setting a record. Do you agree with the overall assessment of, say, 70% turnout?
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, voter enthusiasm.
Not asking for keeping secrets. I'm just trying to figure out the overall.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I don't know the specific number. No one does. I mean, everybody. Yeah. I bet the secretary.
You're building a model. Is that sure? In the ballpark?
Yeah. I mean, maybe the Secretary of State probably has a better handle on it than anybody else in the state or in the country. But you know, I think things will be reasonably similar to what we saw in 2008. Although I know turnout enthusiasm is a little bit lower for the president currently. Obviously, a lot of his support has gone to us.
In election night, you're going to be crunching your numbers, looking around. You know this state very well because you've had to get a PhD in about 7 months here. What's the one place you're going to be staring at all night?
Sure, certainly. I mean, I know that in 2008, Barack Obama won all 10 counties. And then in 2010, Senator Ayotte won all 10 counties.
Yes.
So it's interesting that every single county flipped back and forth. So I think all of them are important, and I know that's not exactly the answer you wanted, but we will absolutely be looking at every corner of this state to look for anything that looks a little bit out of the ordinary.
Obviously, Nashua is very important. At the, in the closing days, you saw Mitt Romney have his last rally here, one of his rallies here on September 7th, Holman Statement. You saw President Obama here in Nashua the last weekend. Rochester is considered a swing, but you know, one place you guys have been focusing a lot of surrogates is Derry. I just was wondering if there's a certain town just looking as I look around the map.
Well, I mean, just right here in Manchester. Manchester in 2004 went for President Bush. In 2008 went for President Obama. Yeah. It's the biggest city in the state, and it's flipped between 2004 and 2008.
And do you think Obi's going to help you with that? I mean, he's a hometown guy. I mean,
yeah, absolutely. And I know Congressman Ginta, obviously, is on, is on the ballot from here as well. So I think those things are both strong positives. Both those guys are great candidates and deserve to be elected.
Your experience in New Hampshire politics, you know, look, you've spent a lot of time in Iowa, as have I. We are a very entitled bunch up here. How would you describe this? You've jumped around to so many different states doing politics. How are we different? How are we unique, would you say?
I think if there's one word I had to pick to describe the New Hampshire voter, it's discerning, but looking at, what have you done for me? And I think that's a lot of the reason why people are moving away from President Obama and to Governor Romney. They look at the last 4 years and they see that things are not the way the president promised that they would be. Governor Romney has a more compelling vision for the future, one that will give us more jobs and less debt, certainly. And I think that's why you've seen people. President Obama won the state by 10 last time around. It's not going to be anywhere near that in either direction, certainly. But he's lost at least 9 points since 2008. So I think that's why. I think people are really discerning. They pay attention to the issues, and they understand that if someone promises something and they don't deliver on it, then maybe you should look at something else.
So my goodness, if I follow your math, the president basically won the state by, if you round up, to 10 points last time, and he's lost 9. Are we going to know the winner of the New Hampshire election on election night, or are we going to be...
I don't know. If I could tell you exactly how efficient every single reporting mechanism would be, then I'd be doing something different.
Yeah, but you guys are prepared for this in order recount, aren't you?
We're prepared for anything.
Sure. Great. Thank you so much for coming.
Yeah, no problem.
I really
absolutely.
Enjoy it.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Glad to be here.
And thank you for watching WMUR.